These people are cowards and they are scumbags.
The hacker at the heart of one of the nation's worst ever cyber attacks, today unmasked as 33-year-old Russian citizen Aleksandr Ermakov, whose other names include Blade Runner and Jim Jones.
They hide behind technology. We will unveil who you are and we will make sure that you are accountable.
The extortionist, the government says, was responsible for stealing the personal data of 9.7 million Medibank customers in October 2022. Names, dates of birth, passport numbers and health records, including HIV diagnoses, drug abuse treatments and abortion procedures, harvested and published on the dark web after Medibank refused to pay a ransom.
We all went through it, literally millions of people having personal data about themselves, about their family members taken from them and cruelly placed online for others to see.
The government, for the first time, invoking world-leading cyber sanction laws, imposing a travel ban and making it a criminal offence to transact with Ermakov, including through cryptocurrency and ransom payments, punishable by up to 10 years in jail.
I think it's really quite significant for criminals out there to think, well, you know, we're going to get disrupted if we pick on Australia, let's go elsewhere.
But Ermakov wasn't acting alone, believed to be part of the Russian wing of the infamous cyber gang R Evil, who've been linked to attacks across Europe, the UK and the US.
It has been a painstaking effort to get to the point of naming this individual, but we continue to investigate others.
The government, hopeful that outing Ermakov will cost him.
We know a lot about Mr. Ermakov through our analysis, and what we do know is that cybercriminals trade in anonymity. It is a selling quality, and so naming and identifying will most certainly do harm to Mr. Ermakov's cyber business.
But in Australia, one cybercrime attack occurs every 6 minutes. So will hacking the hackers be enough to keep us safe?
Katherine Manstead is the Executive Director of Cyber Intelligence at Australia's leading cyber services company, CyberCX. Katherine, do you think Ermakov actually cares that his identity has been revealed here in Australia?
I think he'll be very embarrassed. This is highly damaging for his street cred as a cyber criminal. The Australian government not only has said what his name is, what they know that he did, but they have shared photos of him across the Australian media today. That's really damaging for any criminal's ability to convince other criminals that they're good at their craft, and I think he'll find it hard to get back into some of the criminal gangs that are causing Australia a lot of trouble in cyberspace.
But normally what deters criminals from crime is the ramifications of getting caught. What real impact will these sanctions have on him?
When you consider that Australia is one of the main jurisdictions that's affected by ransomware, which is Mr. Ermakov's stock and trade, that's just one less country that's going to be able to pay him cyber ransoms. In reality, though, this isn't about an arrest yet. I think we have to be quite sober here about the fact that he is a Russian citizen. Russia is a known safe haven for cyber criminals and hasn't cooperated with the Australian government here. So in the face of that, the Australian government's being creative, and instead of looking to prosecute and arrest here at this point in time, they're instead looking to disrupt the very business model of these cyber criminals, which is, I think, good news for Australians.
Does he have any connection with the Russian government?
Look, a lot of Russian cyber criminals have a pretty cozy relationship with the Russian government. And certainly what we do know is the Russian government greenlights their operations. So provided these cyber criminals hurt Australians and they hurt other Westerners and they don't target their fellow Russians, the Russian government gives them a really long leash. And the AFP, the Australian Federal Police Commissioner, has said he took to Russia the names of the people and the organisations wrapped up in this big cyber crime, this hack of Medibank, and got nothing in return. So certainly it is a safe haven, if not a little bit more, for cyber criminals.
Well, now we've shown our devastating ability to unmask hackers and ruin their business model forevermore. Will this deter other hackers from hacking Australia? Basically, is cybercrime over now for Australia?
This is a really good step, and I'd love to see, and I'm sure the whole Australian community would love to see more of it. Will it meaningfully reduce the amount of cybercrime we face in the short term? No. Will it deter other criminals who have a pretty strong financial incentive from entering into this game? Look, possibly not. However, if I was a cyber criminal sitting in Russia, particularly if I was involved in one of those big hacks against Australia, I'd be worried right now that the Australian government had me in their sights.
Then is there a possibility that he might be so shady that he's been outed that it could backfire on us and he and his gang could seek revenge?
Look, I'm not particularly worried about that. And ultimately, that's because what these gangs want is they want to make money. They're coin-operated machines. They're financially motivated. So Ermakov and his ilk, particularly the gangs that have been involved in hacking Australian organisations, absolutely, they'll keep doing that to make money for a financial incentive. I don't think we're in for some type of Hollywood-esque revenge drama here. I think we've got a young man who's probably quite embarrassed and a little bit on the outer of his gang at the moment. And we have, unfortunately, some pretty capable and pretty, I guess, incentivised gangs that will keep coming to Australia because, unfortunately, they see it as a place to hack in order to make money.
Katherine, thank you.
Thank you.